I love the second floor. When we renovated, the flow became really good up here, with the hallway being kind of the center of the second floor. This is my daughter Emma's room. Emma wanted a purple room, but I didn't want to paint it completely purple. So the ceiling is purple. And also we put this purple wallpaper on a white base. I painted the floors white, and even when we redid the floors out in the hallway, I decided to keep the floor. I put this light fixture in here, which is quite large, and someone was telling me it's going to be too big. But I think it actually works because it is big. It's kind of a focal point in this room. I love vintage objects, and I'm crazy about garage sales, going to flea markets. I need to have something vintage in each room. This couch I found at the garage sale, and I had it reupholstered. Also, I made these two cushions. That's a Mary Meco print, which I love. This is also a vintage piece. I brought in a Tiffany box to match the color correctly, and I think it really almost makes the room, this pop-up color. And this desk here, it's a found object. I found it in the garbage, and I had a friend help me to carry it home. And I spray painted it white, yes. This is also a vintage chair. It's a Lucite. I love Lucite because it kind of disappears in a room. And I had this reupholstered as well. So, and she loves this chair. I mixed in black in this room too, because I think that's actually what grounds it. But it's also a room that you can grow into, that is not going to be outdated. Now we are in my office. And the inspiration for this came actually from a Mexican hotel. I think the walls were teal, but I decided to put the teal on the chandelier instead. And then I made the walls brown, which is quite unusual for me. But I mixed in a lot of white to kind of ground the whole room. The shelves are IKEA, but they look very industrial. That's what I fell for. And the desk is actually an IKEA dining room table that I loved as well. And it also got kind of an industrial look to it. When I started to put the room together, I had actually bought a different fabric for the Roman blinds, but it was too boring, so I needed something more fun. So I decided to buy this Mary Meco fabric and make Roman blinds out of that. I always had a vision to have a white Barcelona chair in this room, and the fabric on the cushion is a Pucci scarf. We are now in my bathroom, which is my dream bathroom. We stayed in a spa in Tuscany, and that's where the inspiration came from for this room. I used a lot of different textures. So I used a different tile on the floor, a different tile behind the bathtub, two different tiles in the shower, and another tile as a backsplash. This is used from recycled cork bottles, so it's also eco-friendly. My favorite part of this bathroom is this bathtub, which I absolutely love. It's the most comfortable tub ever. And also the window I love, which I think it's very important for this space. It kind of makes it. This master bedroom is quite small, which doesn't matter to me. We do have some built-in storage, so we can hide all kinds of things here, and we also have a walk-in closet, which is very organized. We have a large deck outside, so for 6 months of the year, we actually have a huge master bedroom. So we open up the doors completely, and we hang out on the deck at night. I wanted to have a blue wall in the back, and I painted these stripes. You can maybe not see it, but it's shiny stripes in the back here, which I love. I use a lot of my own pictures around the house. On this particular wall, I have quite a few pictures of my daughter. Decorating and designing is such a passion for me, so I just can't stop. A big inspiration for me right now are design blogs from all over the world, which I read almost daily. It's such a passion for me. I love the second floor because I designed it as per the way we live as a family, and I wouldn't have done anything differently. I'm very happy with the space.